We often talk about USP. People familiar with the term USP? What does USP stand for? No, it doesn't. It stands for the usual stuff people say. And I want to stress, nothing you're saying is wrong. I would argue if I got your competitors in this room, they'd say similar things. So I'm not knocking what you've said. What I'm trying to sort of say here is maybe we're going to start demonstrating this. And this is this whole idea we call thinking in 3D, which is all about being dramatically and demonstrably different. Anybody experience this? I find no matter whenever I go into an electrical retailer's, I always get the Saturday boy. Whether it's Tuesday morning, Thursday afternoon. And a few years ago, I'd done the research. I wanted to buy a DVD recorder. So I went in with my money in my pocket to spend. I can't name them for legal reasons. Went in with the money to spend. And in I went. And there on the left was a rack of these DVD recorders. So brilliant. But I'm looking at them. The price difference was amazing. So I'm just looking. And obviously looked a bit confused. This fresh-faced young lad comes up to me and says, "Good afternoon, sir. How can I help you?" Just said in the customer care manual of that particular business. I said, "I'm looking at these DVD recorders, but 750 quid, 100 quid. I said, "What's the difference between the two?" He said, "About 650 quid. And then started reading the little red card. Now, I'm not having a go at him. He's what we call a sales prevention officer. And I want to say this again, I'm not blaming him. I'd argue it could be a training issue, a management issue. And the thing is, sales prevention officers exist in your business. Create delighted customers. Now, I know when I use the word customer delight, some people go, "Oh, God, he's been to Disneyland for his holidays. It's one of those sessions." Can I just stress, this is not have a nice day. Customer delight is exceeding customers' expectations. And sometimes the really scary bit of that is, anybody here ever walked into a shop and been relieved member of staff knows what they're selling? Rung up a call centre not to give your mum's inside leg measurement and your dog's middle name to have to get through to someone you want to talk to? I was working with a bunch of entrepreneurs recently, and one of them said, "Yeah, Andy, it's the law firm that rings you back when they said they were going to." Somebody else said, "No, it's the law firm that rings you back." And our definition of customer delight is this. It's surprising customers with the level of service you provide. Now, if I could just stress, it's surprising them in a positive way.
It never fails to amaze me how many businesses have standard letters that, "According to our records, you're 30 days overdue, 60 days overdue, 90 days overdue." How about a letter that says, "Thank you very much for paying us on time. We really appreciate it." I did some work with a law firm where I spoke at their conference and they very, very nicely paid us within 10 working days. And we sent a little letter. And even better for me, they actually asked me to come back and do some more work with them. And I was doing some work in their offices on client care. And these two guys came up to me after a session and said, "Thank you very much." I said, "No, no problem." I said, no problem. "We work in the accounts department. And that letter he sent to the managing partner, he came down and said, 'Well done, guys. It's the first time he's talked to us in 5 years. He said, "Anyway, have you done your invoice for this lot?" I said, "Well, I've not finished yet." He says, "You know what it's going to be. Get it sorted." And I was still at that business the next day, and he walked past the training room and says, "I've got your invoice." On the Monday morning, I walked into my office, and there was the check. Tuesday, I actually got a call from the accounts department, "Have you got your check?" There aren't many accounts departments, in my experience, ring up to check you've been paid. This also shows that you can actually delight finance people as well as normal. No, I mean, you can do it anywhere in the client journey. Ritz-Carlton Hotels. Every member of staff at Ritz-Carlton is empowered to actually spend up to $2,000 to actually delight a customer to solve a problem. Great story of a guy called Chris Hearn staying at the Florida West Keys Hotel with his family for a week. Comes home to be told the tragic news by his 5-year-old son that he's left his best mate, Joshy the giraffe, back at the hotel. For those that have got 5-year-olds, you know the world has now come to an end. He's not having his tea, he's not going to bed, he's not going to school in the morning. Chris told his son a bit of a white lie. He said, "Joshy's having a couple of extra days holiday." That got him to bed and see if they could find a replacement. He didn't need to. He got a call that evening. "Excuse me, have you lost a giraffe?" He went, "Yeah. It's the laundry team here at the hotel. We've actually found him. He's on his way to you." He said, "I don't know if you could help me. I told my son a bit of a white lie. Is there any way you could actually take a picture of Joshy on holiday?" "No problem at all, sir." 2 days later, Joshy arrives in this little package with some Ritz-Carlton goodies, and in it was a beautifully bound photo album with a picture of Joshy sunbathing, a picture of Joshy having a massage, driving down to the beach, chilling with his mates. That's what this stuff is all about. I'm not suggesting all you need to do is start sending photographs of your clients' kids' toys. You've got to work out what this means for you.
And it's simple stuff to do. Give your people permission to do it. If you work at Timpson's, every member of staff at Timpson's is allowed to spend up to £500 to solve a customer's problem on the spot. What can people do in your business to make it work? Southwest Airlines. Anybody here flown Southwest Airlines in the States? They're cheap and cheerful airlines. They're like Ryanair, but they smile. And they believe that their dramatic difference is their people. And they're allowed to say anything that they want to show the character. There's certain legal things they have to say, but here are some of the things their staff have been heard to say. And if you go on YouTube, there's a fantastic video of this guy rapping the instructions. And I'm not suggesting to teach your receptionist or your accounts department how to rap. What I'm sort of saying is, do people buy into this whole idea of what is your dramatic difference? Are they encouraged and allowed to go the extra mile for customers?